Hey guys! So you want an update on our mobile application and our stuff that we are developing. So today, we'll do one for you. We'll make an update. Let's do it. For all of the questions that you guys asked and also some questions from me, I'm joined by Dave.
Hey.
And by Manfred.
Hi.
These two guys are working in the background day and night, mostly nights. Yeah. And they are developing the Android app. Oh, the Android app. Yeah. Oh. We have an Android app right now. We're going into that later. And on the mobile application and also on the website. Yes, there is an update. There are a lot of updates and a lot of questions. So, first off, Android application.
Yeah.
Some guy, and some guys actually, are multiple people, wanted to view their stats on their phone.
Yeah. So, no, you can.
Yeah. Yeah, awesome. So he just made an app in a day.
Yeah, a few days.
Okay.
Yeah.
So what
it's
can he do?
It's the official Modpress app. You can find it on the Play Store. So just download it on your phone.
Link and will be in the description.
Exactly. Yeah, you can watch our videos, of course, follow our progress, what we're doing on YouTube. Also, read our blog, get some in-depth information there, leave comments if you have any questions. And of course, we integrated the Mobro. So.
Yeah, so you can now have all your stats on your phone. And the only thing that you need is to be in the Wi-Fi, right?
Yeah, you have to have the Mobro application running on your PC, of course. Connect the phone to the same Wi-Fi, and that's about it.
Yeah.
If you have multiple Mobro applications running, you have to configure the network name of your PC accordingly on the PC and the app.
Yeah. It's about the right, the thing that we said in the audio video where we told you that you have to set the application name. So that is pretty easy. Check it out. It's in the description down below. It's in the Play Store. It's currently just for Android, right?
Yeah, it's currently for Android. But it's compatible all the way back to Android 5. That's Android Lollipop. So,
yeah, so that's
like really, use
really
your old phone.
Phones. Old phones. So let's talk about the mobile application. So I have seen, here are a few questions from the guys, and they all want customization, they want themes. They've seen all the cool themes like the Portal theme and the, well, what is it? The Fallout theme on the thing. They want that. How do we do that?
So we actually finished the feature that you can switch between themes for the Raspberry and now for the Android application as well, since they're in the same way. The only issue we have at the moment is get that feature for you guys so that you can switch it from the UI. But we are eager to work on that. And we actually had a comment from someone who found out how to switch the theme already. So the feature is out there. It is finished, but we'll get it for you guys out there. If we publish a new version of the mobile application, you will get a green banner on the top. So you can download the new version and just reinstall it, which pretty much gets you the newest version.
Yeah.
So that's pretty easy, yeah. So no problem there. We will start off with the Portal theme, the default theme that we have, and maybe even the theme that we had for the Fallout PC. That they are pre-installed with the mobile application, you can switch just between those. And the nice thing that we have at the moment is our infrastructure. Now that you can even use Android phones to connect to the mobile application, the same way that the Raspberry does, you can switch themes for any of these devices. And we're pretty dynamically adding just new devices as you wish, which is pretty cool.
Yeah, so check that out. And we have all those themes now. What is actually customization? Like, what can we do with all these themes?
Well, we have ideas for that at the moment. We will start to implement these features once we have the themes done. So we are thinking about that you have the possibility to switch boxes. For example, if your graphics card is more important to you than the CPU, you can switch just that card up via drag and drop or something like that. And we're also thinking about giving you the possibility, for example, for the default theme that we have, to switch the background to anything that you want.
Yeah, these are a few questions. So a lot of people said they want to have their own background, they want to put cat images in the background. Some people want to change the color of the font as well. So they have a solid background and like white color. Is that also something that should be possible maybe?
Well, the thing is, what we can offer is that we give the possibility for people who create themes, at the moment just us, but a theme is pretty much able to do anything that you want. It's just a piece of code that does its stuff. So if someone actually takes the time to develop a theme that is able to switch from font color to font to background to whatever crazy ideas you guys have, It will be possible, actually.
So we can make a rainbow farting background.
Yes. Yeah, for, I mean, yeah. You can even have a Fortnite dancer in there if you, have, if you want to.
Please,
no problem at all.
Well, yeah. So maybe we'll do some kind of theme workshop stuff, maybe in the future.
So we will have to create another blog for that and give more insights for developers especially.
There will be a video.
Yeah.
There will be a video and a blog and stuff and
tutorials.
Someday. First off, let's make the theme for you available and then we can talk about that. About infrastructure. You said something about infrastructure.
Oh yeah, we had some questions regarding our infrastructure. If, for example, we need the USB cable that we used in our previous videos, where we connected the Raspberry to the USB port on the motherboard directly. That is not necessary. We just use it for power. We deliver all the data via Wi-Fi. That's why you have to connect the Raspberry to the Wi-Fi beforehand for two reasons. First of all, it's dynamic. We can also use Android phones instead of a Raspberry.
What we're doing now?
What we can now, right?
Download the app.
And the second thing is, GDPR and stuff like that. So everything stays in your local network.
Yep.
We are thinking about a way that you that we send the data to a server beforehand, so you can just use your phone and the website to get the data. But that is an issue that, well, we all know GDPR, especially in Europe.
We're in Europe, by the way. Some people ask, where are you from? Are we Americans? You see, we cannot talk English very well.
No, we're Austrians.
No, we can. We try. We're Austrians, and in Europe, there's a huge thing about data protection laws. It's a good thing, actually, but it's also for developers more work to get adjusted to that. And as Dave said, we want to have some kind of way you get the PC data also outside of your house, not just in your network, so you can also leave the PC turned on and see, well, in your, at work, you're doing stuff with the PC. Is it getting hot? Is it not? You can maybe shut it down someday, but this is also security issues on the computer. We're looking into that. If you have any ideas, just leave them down below. We're happy about the ideas and all the things that you're, well, keep coming up with. Okay. So one of the main questions was, please give us more data.
You shall get more data.
Can we get more data?
So, maybe.
I heard there's a huge issue with data. So tell us, what is the issue with data that we have?
Well, basically, there's a lot of hardware out there, like various different motherboards and stuff, and to get the data from all of the different manufacturers is like hard. So currently,
So what is our solution for that?
Well, we have alternatives.
We have looked at some alternatives, but I don't think we committed on one yet. So we're still investigating what's like the easiest part for us to implement and
So there's more data coming.
There's more data coming, but
it takes time.
Like,
okay. So just so you know why there's no data right now. It's not that we're not reading it and that's there. It's not there.
We would like more data as well, because we're using the app.
We all want to use the app as well, and we all are doing this for us as well. So so we have some more stuff. I think we're done with the questions, but we have a new update on our Mocbros website, and some of you guys have already seen the new theme, the new design. It's already online. It's already on our link, mocbros.com. It's done.
Link will be in the description. Yeah, it's pretty nice. We reworked the whole page, new design. The blog is way more readable now.
That's what
you can still leave comments, so please do, especially on our new pages, like the Mocbros application, where you can actually download the application now more easily.
And there are a lot of people talking on the blog post from the mobile application. There are a lot of tips and hints, and people also have some solutions for various issues that they have. Just keep communicating on there. It's pretty nice to get all these feedback. Thanks.
And one more thing, you can register now on the page and log in. You will get more benefits in the future. We're still thinking about some things that we might arrange for you guys.
But one of the things I've already revealed kind of in the video, we already said that we want to do some kind of monitoring also on the website, so you can just go on the Mocbros website, log into your account, and maybe if the computer is running, see the data online from everywhere in the whole world.
Sadly, we are forced to use logins and register for that.
Of course.
For security issues, of course. we don't want to track anything of that, but what also new on the website? Merchandise.
Oh yeah, merchandise.
Merchandise.
Yeah, yeah. We have thought about that, and people also said, how can I support you? Well, now you can. Just buy some of our merchandise. We're not getting like the full thing, but we're getting a cut of it. And if you want to support us even more, there's also Bitcoin somewhere on the website.
I don't know if the addresses are on the website yet.
But we're going to do it. We're going to do it.
Anything lying around? I think we have some new projects in the future, right?
Yeah. So we're not just developing the application, we're not just doing our only website. We're also working on new PC builds, two currently. I can't go into detail with that, but one is going to be super customization. We're making our own case, at least we try, and we're failing, and we're trying. We're also doing a lot of new 3D printing. We printed wood, we're now printing metal in the future. So yeah.
And a nice little thing, we are currently working on enclosures for our Raspberry Pi units that we use for developing the app.
Yeah.
So, should we say it? I mean, we have a small arcade box, like an arcade console, and what will you do for your enclosure?
I'm not sure yet.
I'm not sure.
Maybe just a display. I'm not sure, but
we have already like three of those working, but we kind of threw them away because they don't look so good.
3D printing is nice! Yeah, so we're trying to do more things. We are going to update you on more videos. It's just taking a while. It's just the MoBro application is really our main focus right now. So you get more data, more stuff, more things. And yeah, that's about it for the video. Thanks for tuning in. If you have any questions, maybe you're going to do this setup again, maybe do some more. FAQ, it's in German. FHQ is just FHQ.
At least at the point.
Yeah.
No, it's Q&A.
Q&A! Yeah, it's Q&A. So, language barrier.
I mean, at the moment that we finish the themes, we will have to do this anyways.
Yeah.
Like
we need to show you how it's done.
Sort of dev block.
Yeah.
So we'll have to do it anyways.
Yeah.
Yeah. So don't forget to subscribe to our channel.
And see you guys next time.